Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding mapping the American mind written by Krishna Kumar. Now this editorial relates to education, so this is important from GS mains paper 2 point of view. Plus you can also use the content of this editorial in answering GS paper 4's case studies and questions on ethics. Now, in order to understand this editorial, first of all we need to identify the contours of this editorial. Now, what is meant by contours? The contours means the basic theme, the core theme, the rooted theme of the editorial. Now, there are three contours of this editorial. First of all, the first basic contour is democracy. Democracy. The second contour is education. And the third contour is neo-liberal ideology. Now this editorial is about the relationship between these three contours. It is about the analysis between these three contours. And what is the context of the editorial? The context of the editorial is the election of the President of United States of America, that is Mr. Trump. Now, according to the author, the American society's education has dwindled. The education level of the Americans, they have deteriorated. Their education has withered. Their education is no longer inclusive. Their education is not progressive. Now, why the author is so critical about the American education system? He is critical because according to him, this witheredness of education in America has led to the electing of Donald Trump. According to author, the people, they have not been able to critically analyze the worthiness of Donald Trump. They have accorded lot of credence to him. They have accorded lot of importance to him. And they have accorded lot of importance to a force which is not virtuous, which is not ethical, which is less moral. According to Krishna Kumar, this was not expected from the American society, because American education system, it has always been believed to be an epitome of education. It has always believed to be an embodiment of rationality, an embodiment of high worthiness, embodiment of liberty, and upholding the modern liberal values. So the education system of America has always believed to be having a standing of higher pedestal. ये हमेशा माना गया है कि अमेरिका का जो एजुकेशन सिस्टम है वो बहुत उच्च स्तरीय का है. जो अमेरिका का एजुकेशन सिस्टम है उसमें लोगों की थिंकिंग बहुत अच्छे से डेवलप हो जाती है. लोग चीजों को अच्छे से डिवाइड करना समझ जाते हैं, क्या सच है और क्या झूठ है, व्हाट इज राइट व्हाट इज रॉन्ग. बट दिस टाइम the people have failed to elect a leader which stands for ethics, which stands for virtues. His approach, his ideology manifests evils. His ideology manifests war. His ideology manifests ultra-rightist approach. His personality manifests fundamentalism. So these are the ideas that an educated society must shun. But American society has adopted a personality which actually stands for these ideologies, for these ideas, for these principles. Now, Mr. Krishna Kumar, he has analyzed the relationship between democracy, election and neoliberal ideology by focusing on the books of two scholars. First of all, he has analyzed the book of John Dewey, that is Democracy and Development. Now, according to John Dewey, education is something that should spread equally, and it should create, it should engender a situation whereby the people should allow collective efficiency, whereby the people should allow individualistic freedoms. जो education है वो सबको एक सम्मान मिलना चाहिए, and उसके बाद जो उसका goal है इस तरह के education system का, वो लोगों को अपना individualistic freedom प्रदान करे. And along with that, the education system should also focus on collective efficiency. Now, what is meant by collective efficiency? Now, collective efficiency here means the people should not be divisive. There should not be a fault line in the society. There should not be division in the society. There should not be attrition in the society. Log aapas mein lade kam. Is tarah ka शिक्षा का जो सिस्टम है वो सेटअप होना चाहिए, अकॉर्डिंग टू जॉन डेवी इन हिज बुक डेमोक्रेसी एंड डेवलपमेंट. एंड द सेकंड थिंग अकॉर्डिंग टू जॉन डेवी इज लोगों का एजुकेशन सिस्टम का इस चीज से पता चलता है, अगर इफ द पीपल आर एबल टू बी कंसर्न्ड अबाउट द सोशल गोल्स इन द सोसाइटी, एंड इफ द पीपल आर नॉट कंसर्न्ड अबाउट द सोशल गोल्स ऑफ द सोसाइटी, then the education system is not good. Then the education, such kind of education system will not promote good democracy. Further, Krishna Kumar has also analyzed another book of Alan Bloom's, The Closing of the American Dream. The title is The Closing of the American Dream. Now, how the American Dream will be closing? Now, before the Reagan era, America had always stood for liberal values, liberty, equality. America had stood for, whereby the state also plays an important role in deciding about the economic forces, in deciding about the social forces, in deciding about the political forces. But after Reagan era, रीगन के आने के बाद क्या हुआ, मार्केट फोर्सेस ने बहुत ज्यादा रोल प्ले करना शुरू कर दिया अमेरिका में, प्राइवेटाइजेशन आ गया. और एलन ब्लूम कहते हैं कि प्राइवेटाइजेशन आने से, न्यू लिबरल आइडियोलॉजी आने से अमेरिका में क्या हुआ है, एजुकेशन सिस्टम का प्राइवेटाइजेशन हो गया है. जो अमीर लोग हैं वो ज्यादा शिक्षित हो पा रहे हैं, जो गरीब है वो शिक्षित नहीं हो पा रहे. Poor are not able to have access to education, whereas the rich people, they are able to have access to the education. This has created divisiveness in the society. Education is not playing its role to enrich democracy. Education is not playing its role in the society whereby it can make the society concerned about the social evils, about the social goals. गरीबी को कैसे दूर करना है, एम्प्लॉयमेंट कैसे जनरेट करनी है, तो ये सोशल गोल्स होते हैं. एक अच्छा एजुकेशन सिस्टम ही इन सोशल गोल्स के ऊपर फोकस करता है. बट व्हेन यू डोंट हैव अ गुड एजुकेशन सिस्टम इन दैट सिनेरियो यू कंट्रीब्यूट लेस टू डेमोक्रेसी. सो एजुकेशन इज अ डायरेक्ट लिंक विद डेमोक्रेसी एंड अंडर न्यू लिबरल आइडियोलॉजी यू हैव क्रिएटेड प्राइवेटाइजेशन. So the education system is less progressive, is less inclusive. So in such a scenario, education is solely focused on achieving materialistic goals. Education's focus has become very myopic. It has become very confined. It has become very narrowed. So according to Krishna Kumar, India should also be concerned about how we are privatizing our education system, how we are creating wedges, how we are creating hiatus, how we are creating gaps, how we are creating disparity in the availability of the education resource. And if the education resource will have a price tag, in that case you will not be able to develop a collective efficiency. You will not be able to develop individualistic freedoms. You will not be able to develop a society which will be more concerned about the social evils. In that case, your democracy will be shallow democracy. So it is very, very important that the state should be playing up its role in providing education. And the change that the education should be introducing in the diversified domains, it should remain intact. The intended focus of the education should not remain confined to just achieving jobs. It should not remain confined to having access to the materialistic goals. But education should have a pious goal whereby people can really feel about the concerns of the society, how to remove hunger, how to be concerned about pollution, how to be concerned about degrading biodiversity, how to be concerned about poverty, how to be concerned about the needs and the welfare of the disadvantaged sections, how to be concerned about the availability of clean drinking water. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.